Aries, welcome back to the channel. Monica Love here at The Love Messages. So today we're going to be doing your reading for November. Now this is going to be a general reading, so it may resonate with you, it may not. If it does resonate with you, there will be a link in the description box for the extended. So Aries, in this reading, I'm going to be taking a look at past, present, and future for you. I'm going to clarify the cards and pull some advice. Okay, so your challenge, Aries, is the sun. And what you don't see coming at the bottom of the deck is the fool in reverse. Okay, so your challenge, Aries, has a lot to do with the sun. I feel like with the sun here, there is something here about you needing to be positive, remain positive, feeling confident. There's something positive that's coming into your life, but you may not see this. This is your challenge. So we're going to clarify the sun and see what the important message is here for you in a moment. Now, in the recent past, Aries, you have the Temperance, the Ace of Wands, and the Knight of Swords. I feel like there was a brand new beginning that happened for you in the past, and it required a lot of patience from you because although it seems, you know, like something amazing for you, new beginning, passionate new beginning with someone, there was some uncertainty here in the past is what I'm seeing with the Knight of Swords, because someone here was rushing in really quickly, okay, rushing in towards you. I'm also getting that this new beginning that happened for you in the past, Aries, was part of the divine, okay? This was something that the divine brought you here in the past. We're going to find out more when we clarify in a moment. Now, in the present moment, you have the Two of Wands, the Six of Swords, and the Justice. So I feel in the present moment, there's a major change that's happening in your life. There's a decision that that you're going to have to make here. A lot of you are moving away from something here in the present moment, or someone could be moving away from you. And it may be that in order for this situation, Aries, to come back into balance and for you to make this decision that you have to make, this person may need to disconnect, okay? We're going to find out why this person may be disconnecting in a moment. Now, in the near future, you have the Hanged Man, the Four of Cups, and the Eight of Cups. It looks like in the near future, someone here is disconnecting. And the reason why they may be disconnecting is because, number one, someone here feels like they're not, they feel like they're not being acknowledged, or they feel like, you know, this person that they're trying to offer love to seems like they're not interested. Or it could be that this person isn't taking action. There's a lack of someone here taking action. And as a result of that, someone just doesn't feel emotionally secure and they disconnect. Okay. So reading isn't going to be for everyone this week, but this is what I'm seeing. We're going to find out why when we clarify. Okay. Now, what you don't see coming at the bottom of the deck, you have the Fool, the Ten of Cups, the Strength, the Knight of Cups, the Devil upright. Wow. And the Emperor in reverse. Okay. So, Aries, what you don't see coming is the fact that there was a situation, or there is a situation in your life where you're dealing with someone possibly who has been emotionally withdrawn from you. They haven't been emotionally available. Your life with this person has become a little bit, you know, tedious, repetitious here. I'm seeing that a lot of you were supposed to have a new beginning with someone. That didn't happen. I feel like you gave up on a specific person who constantly left you in the dark. I feel like you were dealing with someone where things were on and off constantly, and that's what led to a lot of instability between you and this person. I feel like a lot of you are going to recognize, this is what you don't see coming, you're going to start recognizing that there is a person or there is a situation around you that's very toxic. And that's what's leading to the inability for you to move forward, the inability for you to actually take action. You know, Aries, it's really important that whoever we surround ourselves with have our vision in mind, okay? So if you are wanting stability in your life and you haven't been able to do that and you constantly feel stuck, then what Spirit is saying, what you don't see coming is that eventually you're gonna acknowledge what is toxic. Now, this doesn't have to be a person. It could be food that you're eating. It could be the lifestyle that you're leading. It could be the people you're hanging out with. Whatever it is, what needs to be identified here is what is creating this toxicity and what is actually holding you back from moving forward, okay? So this is what I see you doing. You're gonna realize what is holding you back and therefore make changes to therefore move forward, okay? So this is what I'm seeing. Now let's get into your reading and let's see what's going on for you. Let's clarify your challenge, which is the sun. Okay, so your challenge is clarified by the Two of Swords in reverse, the Three of Wands in reverse, and the Magician. A lot of you have to ask yourself a really important question. And the important question that you have to ask yourself is, what is stopping you from being happy? What is stopping you from being able to live the life that you want to live? Okay, there's something here about you having a difficult time being positive regarding some sort of situation. I feel like your challenge here, Aries, has a lot to do with you being open, okay? Being open, being willing to take action. A lot of you may be looking at the circumstances around you and allowing the circumstances of your situation to affect your ability to create, manifest, and do what it is that you want to do in order to be happy. So a lot of you need to go within and you need to figure out who and what you are. And that involves the Magician energy. The Magician here is in reverse. So this is indicating to me that a lot of you feel powerless right now, okay? But what Spirit is saying is that you are able to be happy if you go within and you're open to that. The Two of Swords here in reverse is a card of being open. It's a card of not allowing our past traumas to affect us. So I feel right now your challenge has a lot to do with a need to take action, but a need to take action within yourself and identify what energy and power you have within yourself to create this happiness that you seek in your life, because you want happiness. This is what you're seeking. And now is the time. The time is now for you to take action within yourself to recognize the power that you have to create your happiness for yourself, okay? So this is what I'm seeing as your challenge. Now, let's talk about the recent past. Let's clarify the Ace of Wands in the recent past. Right, so the Ace of Wands is clarified by the Sun in reverse, the Judgment, and the Star. So I feel like in the past, something here happened really quickly between you and someone, you and a specific person. I'm really strongly getting here that there was some uncertainty here in the past regarding this new beginning, but you also could see the potential in it, okay? I'm also getting that this person in the recent past that you had a new beginning with was somebody who started to help you heal, somebody who started to help you see the vision, and this is somebody who helped you really start to get in touch with reality, okay? Temperance is about spirit, and it's about balance. Peace, balance, you know? So this person came in because they definitely felt that you were someone that they wanted to have a new beginning with. So I feel like this person rushed right in. This was part of, you know, your destiny with the Temperance here and the Ace of Wands. So I feel like there was a beautiful new beginning that happened for you, and it's like it happened perfectly for you in the past. Now let's talk about the present moment. In the present moment, it looks like someone here is disconnecting. Tell me more about the Six of Swords for Aries. So the Six of Swords is clarified by the Fool, the Empress, and the Seven of Pentacles. So in the present moment, a lot of you right now, I feel like this is you, you're disconnecting from something. It could be a job that you're disconnecting from, person, place, or thing. Apply it to your situation. I feel like you're disconnecting from the situation areas because you want to grow. You're ready to move to the next level. You're ready to really bring forth some form of balance, maybe even a new beginning in your life. I feel like this is a new direction that you're going to take, and it's part of this new beginning. So if you've had difficulties even having a new beginning in the past, which I see that you have, now in the present moment, a lot of you are saying, you know what, I finally know what it is I want, and I'm ready to disconnect from the situation. And I see you right now thinking about what you're going to do moving forward. Tell me more about the Two of Wands in the present moment for Aries. What's the important message here? So the Two of Wands is clarified by the Ace of Cups, the Three of Pentacles, and the Knight of Cups. So lately I've been seeing the Ace of Cups in your reading for almost every reading, and it looks to me like you're moving into a new direction with someone here that you really love. This person's ready to offer you love. This person's ready to go on this journey with you. I'm also seeing that a lot of you have a decision. You don't have to accept this love offer from this person, but for most of you, you're choosing to do that because you're now ready to completely move away from something that hasn't been fulfilling for you. So it looks like in the present moment, Aries, a lot of you are taking a risk on something new because you're ready to grow, and that's what's gonna bring balance back into your life. This situation that you are moving towards is gonna bring balance, because if you see these two cards, how they're positioned, you see the person with the Six of Swords is moving towards the Justice, which means balance. So you're moving towards a real relationship, something that's solid, something that's stable, something that's going to lead to something long-term here in the present moment, okay? Now, in the present moment, it gets interesting because things change, okay? So even though it seems amazing and great in the present moment, it looks like things are going to change. And this is something that you need to be aware of in the near future, okay? So we're going to clarify and we're going to see. First card, someone here stops taking action with the Hanged Man. Why is that? Let's clarify the Hanged Man. So the Hanged Man is clarified by the Five of Cups, the Two of Pentacles, and the Three of Cups. I'm really strongly getting that there's going to be somebody here from your past that tries to connect with you. This is somebody who's been, like, either they lack taking action or they have a problem taking action. And I feel like this person may decide to, you know, reconcile with you or come back together with you, and a decision has to be made here, because whoever this person is, there's somebody who doesn't take action. There's somebody who they wallow, right? They get into this place of being emotionally dragged into something here that affects them, and they're someone who is not able to see the positive side of things. Okay, I don't feel like this is you. I feel like this is somebody that you may be dealing with, or somebody from your past. Okay, so I do see a reconciliation happening here, or a decision that needs to be made about a possible reconciliation with someone here that, you know, things may have not worked out. And I'm also getting in the near future that a lot of you reject this person. Like, it's as if you're not interested in them. Tell me more about the Four of Cups. Why is the Four of Cups here? So the Four of Cups is clarified by the Five of Pentacles, the Queen of Swords, and the World. Yeah. So it's really clear that someone here who left you or who abandoned and disconnected tries to offer you love again. And a lot of you are at this point where you're like I told you, it's over. It's done. It's been over. So even though you're disconnecting in the present moment, someone here doesn't believe that you're doing that. They think it's a joke. They're like, yeah, okay, whatever. Aries is going to come back to me. But it looks like, Aries, a lot of you are tired of being held back. You're tired of being in a situation where you're not feeling fulfilled, okay? With the Eight of Cups here, we look at someone who's walking away, and we have the full moon there. So someone here has enough. Enough is enough. In the near future, someone says, no, I'm moving on to something bigger and better, okay? And I think that that's you. All right, let's get some advice for you. What is the advice? The advice for you, Aries, is the Nine of Cups, the Two of Cups, and the Six of Cups. The advice here is to ask yourself if someone from your past is really bringing forth the type of relationship that you want. is this person from your past bringing the fulfillment that you want? Because what your focus should be on right now is, yes, it's okay to have a relationship, it's okay to be with someone, but create the memories that are going to bring fulfillment to you. If something in your life is not bringing you fulfillment, then you really need to ask yourself if this is the type of relationship that you want. I see a relationship coming into your life if it hasn't already, if that's something that you want, but your main focus should be on bringing happiness to yourself, because by bringing happiness to yourself, that's what allows you to create memories and also cherish a relationship that you want to grow moving forward. Okay, so make sure you're not forgetting about yourself, even though you are connecting with somebody very strongly here in a relationship. Okay, so Aries, this is what I have for you. I hope this reading helped. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I'll see you on the next one.